All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of, we don't really know what this channel is called.
Yeah, we don't really know yet, so.
All we know is that today we're going to be doing a battle between two albums.
Two somewhat beautiful, extravagant, like erotic.
I think one of them at least is incredible. Erotic. A masterpiece. But today we're going to do something different,
right? Very erotic.
We're going to be comparing Don FM, the Weeknd's new album that just came out,
Last week, right?
4 days ago, dude. Maybe like three. We're going to be doing a battle between that and After Hours, which was the Weeknd's last album that he made.
Mm-hmm.
So, we both have our opinions.
Look, for starters, After Hours should have gotten a Grammy. 100%. He got snubbed from that one.
Now, Don FM, though. Don FM has some interesting vibes.
It has some great potential.
Before we say what we think about Don FM and After Hours, this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna play each song from each album. So the first song from Don FM against the first song of After Hours. And then we're gonna vote and see who gets the point. Whoever has the most points essentially wins the album, right? Mm-hmm. Now we are taking out Blinding Lights from After Hours because
I mean, let's be real. All right, Blinding Lights was just It was a masterpiece. It was on top of the charts for weeks
and it still is.
Months. And
it's still in the top 100.
It's still there. You know, like everybody loves Blinding Lights. It's almost like everybody knows what Blinding Lights is. It'll win no matter what.
Plus, it makes it even because there's 16 songs on one and 16 songs on the other one. So yeah.
There's
perfectly even for both of those.
There was 17 songs
with Blinding Lights, so that's why we took it out.
With Blinding Lights, yeah, and then Don FM has 16.
Right.
So it's matched up perfectly.
So that's what we're about to do, right? So up first we have.
Well, I mean, before we get into it, I just want to say, of course, y'all will have your own opinions, stuff like that. So whoever you think that is gonna win,
right?
Drop it in the comments below.
This is complete opinion based. So if we say something that you don't like,
please, is
just our point of view, right? Yeah. It doesn't have to be yours, but we're just saying like what we think about it.
Yeah, I mean, like we're not trying to, you know, legit dawn on anybody's, you know.
Let's just get on with it, right? First up, we got Alone Again from After Hours, which is the first song. So here we go.
I just want to say that this is probably one of my favorite intros of all time.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
With the long shot. Take off my disguise.
The spatial audio all around it, yeah.
It's just crazy, man. Spatial audio, by the way.
Spatial audio, yeah.
Yeah, we'll talk about that soon.
Oh, here it goes. The harmonies.
The harmonies, just the way he's really attacking.
And the way you can hear like two at the same time, yeah.
Yeah. In a car, this thing thumps. This song thumps, bro.
Yeah. This is where it changes though, and it gets.
This is what's winning me over right here.
Okay, let's see.
Essentially, is this transition
right here. Gotta see.
Like this change up and everything is just.
Keep in mind, we make music, so we're looking at this in the producer's slash
more of like the artistry, just like the
mixer type way, yeah.
Like just I just can't right here.
I think it's good, but I don't think it's like.
Come on, bro.
Okay, yeah, I mean, I feel like it's good. It's good, but
it's, like, it is legit one of the perfect, like, intros from an album. Because it's...
I beg to differ, because we're about to play the next song. So that was the intro
song. That was Alone Again.
Alone, and I feel like that's more... Like, it has more of a vibe that you want to dance. Like, you're in a... Like, I don't feel like...
I feel like Alone Again, it feels like the intro to, like, this crazy cinematic movie.
I actually do feel like that's more for, like, when you're riding in your car, like, at night.
Absolutely.
And you're going really fast, and you're just... Lights all around you. Just like the Blinding Lights bit, I think I've just kind
of... So, let me ask you this. How often do you go out for a drive.
All the time.
Exactly. By yourself, I hope, right?
Yeah.
Exactly. Sometimes with a girl, you know. Mm-hmm. This was definitely one of the songs that I would play. I still play now.
Really?
Yeah, I still
play now. So if you had a girl in your car right now.
Yes.
Out of all the songs that we're about to go through, this is the one that you'd play for.
This is one of the songs, yeah.
Okay, well.
You know, on this.
We'll talk about the song that I would play.
Okay, look.
In a minute, once we get to it, right?
Look, I mean, there is another song that I would play over anything. Okay. You know.
Okay, we'll get to it in a minute.
Yeah,
then.
But I've kissed many girls to this song.
To this song?
To this song.
It's your choice for sure, right? You're the one who plays the song.
No, it's just so happy. Well, it's because I have playlists, okay. Right? And there's one that's called Bangy Bang, which, you know, put the two and two together. And then also got, I forgot what it's called, but it's just called, like, Play This When You're With Her, right?
Right. So Alone Again just happens to be that song that
yes.
you get Alone really Again lucky just, with.
Yeah, I get super lucky with. Like,
maybe I should try, because like, I've never played joking. Alone Again when I'm in a car with anybody.
Exactly, so. Which is kind of ironic, right? Because, like, you know, I kiss them, wind up dating and stuff like that, you yeah. know, and then I just wind up alone again.
Now that is deep, my friend.
Tell me that's not facts.
Oh. This okay. is Dawn FM. First song from Dawn FM.
You know, for those who saw our last podcast, we used know exactly this what this sounds like.
Now, I think this is incredible. I'm gonna shut up just because I just. Mm. It's just, you feel like something amazing is about to happen.
I feel welcome, actually.
I feel like,
you are now listening to 103.5 Dawn FM.
Jim Carrey.
You've been in the dark for way too long. Mm. It's time to walk into the light and accept your fate with open arms.
It's a show, it's like scared? I'm at Disney.
Don't worry, we'll be there to hold your hand and guide you through this painless transition. But what's the rush? Just relax and enjoy another hour of commercial-free music on 103.5.
Dude.
Okay, before we get into it. Okay, so before we get into the next song, I just want to say Jim Carrey killed it. Killed it.
I think it's the best person the possible.
Like he's creepy.
He
you know
is,
what I'm saying?
Yes.
Like, as funny as he is and as sad as he is, you know, if
he's
you really think about it.
He's the perfect vibe for this, which yeah. I never would have expected able to get
Jim Carrey.
Like,
out of
awesome.
All people.
Yes.
Out of all people. You know, but before he released who was going to be on the album, I was watching Dumb and Dumber, right?
I was watching Sonic.
And then the day after, I found out Jim Carrey was on the album.
I know. I was watching the Truman Show not long ago. So
dude.
That was beautiful.
It's such a great.
Now, here's my thoughts between Dawn FM and After Hours.
Okay.
Dawn FM was very short compared to After Hours. I mean, Alone Again, right? Obviously, like, Alone Again, there was more thought,
It's more of a song.
But there was just that little piece that just made me feel like this is going to be the best album ever. Now, when I heard this, I immediately thought, and I said to myself, this is going to be the best album that Weeknd has ever made. When I heard Dawn FM,
okay.
At that point, right? Because mm-hmm. I hadn't heard the other mm-hmm. songs yet, but at that mm-hmm. point, I was sure it was going to beat After Hours.
Absolutely. So
bring yourself back to that time you heard Alone Again and you heard Dawn FM.
Dude.
Do you give it to?
Okay, I give it to Alone Again.
Really?
Yeah, just because like Alone Again is just like, to me,
uh-huh.
it was so uplifting.
Right.
It was just like, I didn't feel sad, but I did at the same time. It was like, I felt really empowered.
Right. But, that's good.
But depressed at the same time.
Okay.
And Dawn FM, like, again, I'm not saying that it's, you know, as worse, essentially.
Right.
But It's just barely missing.
There's no real meaning in it, right?
Yeah, it's missing like that spice to it.
Exactly. Like, you know, it was beautiful for that split second.
It's a great intro.
Right.
To an album that is basically based on a lot of transitionals.
Right. I guess the point that's gonna take the first win goes to After Hours.
Dawn FM. Oh.
What?
Alone Again.
Yes, that's what I want.
Yeah.
Okay, just making sure we're on the same track.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right, so Alone Again wins this one, and I agree with you on that.
Was that another pun?
It wasn't.
On the same track?
Next song. I completely forgot what I said. Anyways.
Next song.
Next song we got... We got Too Late.
Oh.
From After Hours. I can remember jamming this song so hard in the car with so many bros, so many girls.
There you go, that's better.
But nothing compares to this. And the voice, how it changes, yeah, amazing.
I know, dude, it is such a great vibe.
This right here is my favorite part right here.
Like, come on.
Like, it gets the way that changes. That's so awesome.
Like, y'all, like, y'all have to agree.
You know, like,
yeah, like, it's... Man.
And how that hits your ears, like, going from behind. It's so awesome. It's coming back. It's coming back. And it just breaks. Right here, amazing.
Oh,
ending.
Dude, menacing. Oh, that reminds me, boy. That reminds me.
What?
The music video.
Yes.
Did you ever watch
right here,
the
this
video?
Part with the girl when she pumps out and she's with the knife?
No. Right here.
Yeah,
right,
yeah.
Right here, they were closing the doors.
Yeah, they were closed. That's right. She's about to come through.
And I instantly thought.
Yeah, right here.
Right there.
Yes.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. But so scary.
You know how the bass stops right before it hits the beat though? It's like, it makes you think that it's gonna go bam, 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 but it does. It goes bam, bam, bam.
Yeah.
You know, like, oh, masterpiece, bro.
Yeah.
Masterpiece.
So whenever I first saw the music video, right?
It was awesome. Like, it was. It's probably not everybody's vibe. Right?
A good share of jerkings was. A fair share of jerkings was, you know,
what the heck do you mean by that?
Donated.
Jerkings. What's a jerking? I'm very ignorant when it comes to jerkings.
Well, we'll just skip past that part. So Too Late, right? Phenomenal. The music video, great.
Even better.
Song, great. Like, there's no complaining about it. Like, very underrated
song.
There's nothing
about this song that I'm like, this could be done better.
Nothing. Exactly, nothing.
Like, I just love the way it is, and I enjoy it, and it's my favorite song from this.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, and the thing that I was going to say, whenever I saw the music video,
yeah,
I instantly thought of American Horror Story. Have you seen that?
Yeah, I haven't, but I've seen the trailers, and yes. Like, I feel it's the same vibe.
Yeah, I'm a huge American Horror Story fan.
Which makes sense.
It's awesome.
One of the things that I'm like, would be cool eventually is if The Weeknd made like a cameo on the show.
Dude,
I can imagine.
I've been wanting that for so long.
Have you seen the new music video that just came out today from The Weeknd?
No, I haven't. I've been like
gory, dude. He's getting more
really, really
on that yeah. I said we go play the next song from Dawn FM, which is the second one. And
which one is the second one? I kind of forgot.
The second one is Gasoline.
Oh, good segue.
So here we go.
Talking about killing somebody.
Gasoline.
I just got to start off by saying, great intro.
This right here, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Amazing.
Let me look at the lyrics. At this point, I'm like, okay, what's going to happen? It's driving on my time again. I've sunken up the moon. Now, this is a very different singing style.
Yeah, it's
like,
it's
I've
a
never
very...
heard him sing in a low note.
Well, it's almost like he added a different voice. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, like I'm used to hearing him going like, ah, but now he's like very.
That's what I'm saying.
Kinky. You know, like I'm feeling like some kind of rich one. So like,
that's also what I'm thinking. Are you just quoting the music video?
No, is that what he said?
Yeah. Ah, felt that.
I thought I would be mid, honestly. Okay. Like, it's not something that I would replay again. No, I think out of this whole entire album, this is the one song that I dislike the most.
Okay. So this is what I was gonna say. I totally agree with you.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that it's a bad song. If anything, I got very
honestly though, it's like
I got like
there's not that much production into this. Like
really?
I mean there is, but it's like very repetitive, just I don't know. I just didn't feel like
it definitely did not live up to
Too Late. Like yeah, if you compare it to Too Late, Too Late was just everywhere. Yeah. Synths, you got drums hitting so hard.
Yeah.
Voice changing.
Mm-hmm.
He made something different here. He kind of sang in a lower tone.
He was really going back in time, almost.
I guess to his older albums, right?
No. Like in just music in general. Because some of that, you know, like The Weeknd does really good. Recently, he's been kind of going back to like the 80s type style.
He has been going a lot back to it, but yeah. I don't know why. Like, this is not something that I would just like buy to, you know?
I got you. I would definitely play this. Probably not as often though, it's definitely in a playlist somewhere. But yeah, it's. I mean, to me, it's a great song. You know, it is.
I had a lot of high expectations for the next song right after the introduction.
Absolutely.
Which I'm like, it's about to be awesome.
This is actually exactly why I thought the first half of the album was.
Yeah,
shit.
And I was like, this is kind of mid.
Yeah.
So this is an easy win for Too Late.
Yeah, but
easy dub.
Something that I was gonna say was what he's talking about in the song. You know, it sounds happy, right? You know, like the beat. You know, gets you like jumping a little bit. You know, it's very poppy.
Until you're like, oh shoot, this guy wants to die.
Yeah, he's talking about killing himself.
Yeah.
And it's just like, you know.
And that just depends. That. You know, some people can relate. Others really can't, so I'm just kind of like, you know, yeah, he's sad, but like, I'm not really that sad.
You know.
Depends on what you're feeling, but even then, you know, I feel like there's some sad songs that you're like, okay, I get it, but it also makes you feel a certain way. This is just like, it doesn't really hook you in the way of making you be like, oh yeah, you know.
Well, that's
like
the
Alone
thing,
Again
right?
did for you.
Yeah, but that's the thing though, right? Is that with this song, he wants for you to be jumpy, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, like that's the style that he wants. But he's saying some very dark and twisted lyrics,
right?
To hide behind the happiness, you know, to kind of like blind you. Blinding Lights reference. Don FM can easily make a comeback, though.
We'll see. We'll see.
yeah, we'll see.
What's next?
Oh, Hardest to Love.
Hardest to Love is the third song from After Hours.
I
actually haven't heard this in a while.
I have
heard
a
it once.
Very strong opinion about this song.
So it's gonna be like my first time hearing it.
I have a very strong opinion about
this
song.
Let's see. I'll look at the lyrics, because I actually like, I've listened to this once. You try with me so many times. You're crying up behind a smile. And I can see right through the light. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, I love the bass, like the drum kick.
You're
It sounds like a door stopper, you know? Little door stoppers. When you do that.
Oh, yeah.
It just sounds like that. Yes. Yeah. That's what it sounds like.
Amen. Amen. Wow. So, oh yeah, and then there's this little thing. All right, stop.
Yeah, got it.
Okay. Because it does like a whole transition
thing. Right, right.
So Hardest to Love, again, I have a very strong opinion.
What is your opinion?
I never really, really enjoyed it that much. You know, like this song to me was gasoline.
Basically, I'm listening to this for the first time again because it's been so long.
Yeah.
When it comes to just the actual song, at least just the production part of it, like, it's beady, but it's not something that I would like. It sticks with me, right?
Yeah, yeah. It's very different. I would say it's very, very different. It's very, like, I would call it, like, hyper drill.
Like, yeah.
Yeah.
I guess.
Like if Pop Smoke made, like, a pop song like
interesting.
This.
Interesting.
Okay. I find this more drill, even though it's not drill.
Yeah.
But,
I just don't find it very, like, catchy. I mean, it is if you listen to it enough, but not on the first time.
No,
you
know? it doesn't stick with me that much. Yeah.
Anyways, that was Hardest to Love. Now, on .fm, we got How Do I Make You Love Me, which... Right here, I'm like, okay. We're going
back in time. You know, it's a great show.
It's alright, like, nothing too crazy.
You know, I got a lot of Daft Punk vibes.
Yes, I get it all the time.
Yeah, but that's probably just because he's worked with Daft Punk a lot, so...
I'm pretty chill about this. I'm noticing that it starts changing a little.
Yeah, I also noticed that recently.
And all of a sudden, you get hit with this. Completely off guard.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what the heck am I listening to?
Yeah.
I understand
what I'm saying.
Like, I'm being a simp right now, and I'm okay with it.
You know, I just tweeted that out. I'm like, I will admit it. I'm a simp. Like, I am.
Sometimes we gotta be.
Exactly.
If you think about it. Right here. It doesn't faze you. I need a breakthrough. I only want one try to. This right here is what I can relate. It's quite unusual. Seeking approval. That's it, right. It's like, I don't usually seek approval, but for this specific girl. How do I make you love me? How do I make you fall for me? And it gets intense because it's like, she's singing in a way that you really want this girl. You're like, how do I freaking make you
exactly.
love me, bro?
It's like, you know, what was crazy. I'll talk about it in a second. It'll be very quick. Wait.
This is even better. This is even better. Instrumental masterpiece right here.
Oh yeah, I forgot that there was that instrumental part.
I do agree with this song when it's like, you know, you're usually not singing to a girl like, how the heck do I make you love me? Because you say you're the prize. And 1000% of the cases you are the prize. And I still think I'm always gonna be a prize. But sometimes, you know, just emotions get to you where you just feel like, how the frick do I make you love me?
You know, I could.
Even though she might not be that.
I'm telling you, I just got so much. Now, right here.
And this is just, I enjoy this instrumental right here.
Except, you know, it doesn't transition to, you know, that song right now. But. Just to start, you know, this song wins. All right,
like, this song, yeah.
This song tops.
No lie about
tops
it.
Tops Hardest to Love.
1 point.
Yeah,
so two against
two.
Two one.
But that is so true. It's like the moment you see that girl, right? You know, Like,
and it doesn't happen. I think it's like it I can relate to it often. In the way that from my childhood, right? I can tell you that right now, I don't relate to it in any way whatsoever. But I do see little me relating to it, like little absolutely. Aaron being completely oblivious about anything dating wise, right? Uh-huh. And being desperate and being like, how do I make you love me, right? Mm-hmm. So you, the way this plays to me is like, you become this hero, this absolute amazing thing, and you're kind of like in this very high spot, and you're asking this girl, how do I make you love me, as in like, you both are in the same level. But in reality, like when I was in my childhood years, mm-hmm. I didn't feel confident enough to do that. You know, I was just like, how do I make you love me? Like, please love me, because yeah, I like, didn't please. Feel...
Like, give me that though. Attention.
I do feel like I've changed so much, and I don't relate to this song at all, but I just, you know, just took me back. Oh, just dude. Took me back to little me being like, and it's fun. I love this song. It's just so catchy. It's everything about it is so good.
So
awesome song.
I still relate to this song.
Yeah. All right. So next up, we got Scared to Live from After Hours.
I'm gonna start crying.
Cry.
Did you hear the SNL version of this one?
When I saw the signs, I should have let you go. But I kept you beside me. And if I held you back, at least I held you close. Should have known you were lonely.
Now where the hell did the banana come from? It was an apple yesterday.
I know last things time. Will never be the no. same. Tell me loves will never be replaced. I thought
good. You forgot I was just about to say. I actually do like it a lot.
No, don't be scared to live again.
It's like my first time listening to it again. Because I don't listen to it as much. Okay, we got our battery, so we're restarting this again where we left off. Just missed out on some important conversations that we're not gonna repeat, considering we're gonna get canceled for them. Anyways,
you ever done like ASMR?
I have not.
Oh,
so exactly. Next up is Take My Breath.
I mean,
from
let's Donovan. Just, I mean, okay.
Right here.
Tell me, if you have headphones on, this just sounds crazy.
I saw the fire in your eyes. I saw the fire when I look into your eyes.
Anyways, so.
So, Scared to Live again. Take My Breath, Scared to Live. Wins.
I like Take My Breath, but only the instrumental about it. Like, I love how it's so catchy, but Scared to Live was just a masterpiece.
It was such
like
a masterpiece.
Lyrically, and it was just, it was awesome, right?
The topics that came out of that song.
Yes, I know, because you were like, I'm scared to live. Yeah. And like, why are you scared to live? And then,
man, it was so stupid. But yeah.
Nevertheless, we're going to keep it from what the title actually says. So we're comparing After Hours to Don FM.
Yep.
Next up.
Snowchild.
Snowchild, baby. Let's go. Let's see it.
Then I probably make my wrist bleed. Not to miss you. Or I don't mind like you pay me. I just got a new deal with Mercedes. Got me moving dirty like I'm Swayze.
It's a very different vibe, to be honest. Alright. Thoughts?
Dude, it was just like, I really do like that song.
Yeah.
I do. It's very...
What do you like about
it's
it?
It's very high up there. You know what? That's the crazy thing.
You don't know.
I don't know. It's just... I just love it so much.
I didn't like it that much. to be honest.
I want to say, like, for me, it was more just, like the vibe of it, you know? I really dig the vibe of
it. I get it. I think it's just not my vibe, you know what I mean? Yeah, like, my vibe is more, like, kind of, like, too late. Like, very hardcore beat on. This is more, like, chilling. And
I don't know. I've definitely shed a lot of tears.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, so maybe you like it because you have an emotional attachment to it.
Yes, absolutely.
I don't, so I'm like...
A lot of this album, I'm very attached to. Emotionally.
Yeah, it's a good album.
It's a great album.
And it sounds amazing as well.
Yeah.
So what's it up? It's again Snowchild versus Sacrifice by Dawn FM. All right, let's see. This is going to be interesting.
This one is interesting.
Because the music video just came out. Oh, this reminds me of... A remix of Michael Jackson's Thriller. Or like the part two of it, right?
That's what I'm saying. In a city
where the winter nights don't ever sleep. I love the guitar, dude. No, it's not the guitar, it's the bass. What instrument is that? Bass, right? Yeah.
What's crazy is that it hasn't even gotten to the chorus.
I know.
Yeah. The chorus is the best part.
I'm a dance for this one. Hey. Ooh, right here.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have to give this one to Dawn FM just because.
Yeah, dude, this one
is amazing. Yeah, it was so good. I liked it. Yes,
that one is really good.
Before, baby. All right, let's see what's up next. Escape from LA from After Hours. Let's see what that is.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Another emotional attachment.
Yeah, I actually have a funny joke about this one. But yeah, I've fucked with the song. Yeah, I'm serious. Like,
wait, you want me to leave this in here?
Yeah, I will look in the camera and say it.
Say it. Look at the camera. Say it.
I have fucked to this song not once, but four times. How much did you have? Four times. You know.
Anyways,
so I really like this song a lot. Like, crazy a lot.
I'm neutral about it, you know? I don't know if I like it, I don't know if I don't.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what it's up against. This is interesting because it's not really much of a song.
No.
It's called A Tale by Quincy from Dawn FM.
Looking back now, I didn't know what it was supposed to be. And it's like raising kids, man. If you weren't raised, you don't know how to raise, you know? I just did the best thing I could with them because they know fucking well I love them. But I did do the best I could. I didn't know what the fuck I was doing. I didn't.
So
this would have been a good follow-up to the topic we talked about before, that the camera didn't get because it died, about you growing up without a father.
Yeah.
It's essentially a story. It doesn't really count as a song. I mean, it's a good story, but
it's a very good story. Essentially, what Quincy is saying is, like, he was talking about, like, seeing the death of his mother, like, right in front of him, essentially. And it's very interesting how Abel or The Weeknd put this story into.
Do you think it's true? It's true. Album. It has to be.
Yeah. Okay. It is true. Quincy is going to talk about it, but other than that, I mean, we have to give it to, you know.
I mean, because it's a song. Yeah, like it's, I mean, it doesn't really compete that much, you know.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Here we go, baby.
Never need a bitch, I'm on a bitch need. Try to find the one that can fix me. Try to love me, but they never.
This right here, the bass.
Wow. Cause I'm heartless, and I'm bad to my ways. Cause I'm heartless. All this money, all this pain, I'll be heartless.
Amazing! amazing, amazing production. Amazing. I think it's just fantastic. The Weeknd at its finest. You know, he's saying basically, I'm heartless. Like, he's a menace. He doesn't give a crap and
does not give a shit.
And the audience just goes for it, right? The audience is, we're happy with it.
Honestly, I mean, there are times where we should be heartless.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, but that's, again, different podcast. I feel like we should have another segment where we talk about what was missed.
That's what we were. Yeah.
Yeah, we should have another segment where we legit talk about
what we talked about when the camera died.
Yeah.
Which was incredible.
Yeah, it's eye opening. I swear. Like, no.
This is all we've been waiting for.
So, okay, before you play this song, Heartless has my heart. But this song.
This song is good, but I.
This song.
We'll hear it first, okay? So, we got Out of Time by Dawn. This is a different vibe, though. It's a.
The last few months I've been working on me, baby. Dude, I just want to dance like a girl, bro. There's so much trauma in my life. Say.
Tough,
tough battle. This was actually the one I've been dreading.
Yeah, no, I've been. I like this a lot.
I'm just gonna say it.
Heartless.
No.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Shut up right now.
Yeah.
Dude.
Out of time.
Like, I feel it. Like, it's just two different vibes, but they're both really good. But I still feel like Heartless just makes me feel like a menace. Heartless just makes me, I don't know, it makes me feel a certain way. This just makes me also feel a certain way, but Heartless overpowers me, you know what I mean?
Yeah, this one is legit unfair.
Draw?
No, we can't.
Heartless. Okay, well, so fine. why do you like Out of Time so much?
It's just like...
It's a vibe, right? Like, you like the vibe.
I love the vibe way more than Heartless. Actually, you know what? God, I can't believe I'm actually about to say it. Sure, I'll go Heartless. I will go Heartless.
Okay, fine. It's just, wait. You know what? I like it too. It doesn't matter. Let's give it to Don FM because at this point, it doesn't look like it's gonna win.
How about?
Well, let's just give it a
draw. Win. Draw it. Draw.
Sure, draw. Yeah. So far, score is the same. They're both really good. They're both amazing. What's next? We got this!
Hit it.
I'm gonna have so much fun with this one.
Underrated song.
Very.
Underrated song. Underrated song.
Here it comes, dude. Brace yourself.
What I'm saying, dude, it puts you on a different, you know, atmosphere. It would go into Blinding Lights, but
Blinding Lights would automatically take the win.
Yeah, but yeah, 100%.
Well, let's see what it's up against. Let's see what we got.
This is the one with Lil Wayne?
No.
Oh, yeah.
Celebrating Super Bowl. This love
love is strong to me. Some things can change, go wrong with me. We don't know how it's going to be. Forever is too long to me. We don't need the government involved because we like to touch. We don't need no damn religion telling us that we in love. But if we did crash down the road, spending lawyer fees up, pen and pad gon' save my ass if these feelings freeze up. You gon' sign this clean 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 up.
And I think it's funny because I don't know if you saw that the analysis they made about this song. He's saying, like, my new girl, she a movie star. Now, the Weeknd was seen out going out with Angelina Jolie.
Oh,
so
yeah.
So he's basically, like, is he confirming that he's dating Angelina Jolie?
That.
Which, if he did, dude, man is pulling.
Pulling skeletons.
Pulling.
Skeletons.
Maybe he likes Minecraft. You never know. Anyways, it's good, but it's faith takes the prize on this one.
Faith, 100%.
Faith is just 100%. Incredible. And this is chill, but it's not. It's good, but
definitely at first, I thought Tyler's part was, you know, kind of lagging.
Yeah.
But yeah.
From
like the first time, like I heard it though.
Yeah.
Like you know, it's
yeah, it's alright. Faith. This is a fun one.
Oh,
this is a fun one.
Great music video. Great music video. Very funky.
Very.
I don't know. I'm ashamed of what I've done, yeah. When I look at you in your eyes, I see there's something burning inside you. Oh, inside.
Funk, you know, like, I don't know, there's something
it's movie about it. Yeah, it's very like disco pop.
It is very, you know, disco pop. Like, and
oh man, and legit, I was talking to a you know, an ex of mine, right?
Okay.
And
another one.
Anyway, so she was like, why do you like my eyes so much, right? Not like this is her talking to me.
Okay.
Right. I was just like, I don't know what it is. It's just like there's I think I actually made like a corny line. I was like,
does she know I call you Pooh Eyes?
No.
Does she know people call you Pooh Eyes?
No. I just don't think so.
We gotta fix that.
That song reminds me of that.
Makes sense.
A lot.
I wonder what it's up against.
This one's gonna be a hard
this
one too.
This is gonna be a very hard one, and I think it's the hardest one here because I love both of these songs just as much. Nevertheless. Yikes, dude.
I can see Jim Carrey bobbing his head to this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's like,
oh, what we got.
Yeah.
Baby, what we got is secure. Been a part of toxic love. It tore us apart. Things you want, I'm not looking for. You're my best friend now. You're my best friend now.
Come on.
Oh, I want
my
to be
Lord.
Responsible for your heart. Oh. If we fall, 'cause I'll get clumsy and tear it apart. I love it so, but we can't get close. You're my best friend now. You're my best friend now. Friends no more. Sex as friends no more. You don't wanna have sex as friends no more. Friends no more. Ooh. Friends no more. Sex as friends no more. You don't wanna have sex as friends no more.
Amazing. Amazing. It's such a good song. My vote, I give it to Donovan. Best Friends.
Absolutely.
I love In Your Eyes.
Yeah, I love it too.
Love this one.
I love it too, but this one is just crazy. Little, you know, fun fact.
I've already cried to this song. I haven't.
Yeah.
And I won't. But I relate to it. You know what I mean?
Yeah. But Don slowly coming back. Don slowly coming back.
Shoot, you're kind of right. Honestly, I wasn't expecting this to happen, but this is gonna be a little hard.
Why?
I think it's a classic. I don't know. The music video, perfect. Amazing. What do you think about it?
Yeah.
Well, all right. Let's see what it's up against.
That song was actually at the bottom of the album.
Really? Mine was Gasoline, dude.
We're on two different pages. Yeah, I was talking about After Hours. That song was at the bottom.
Oh, yeah. Right. Well, here's Don FM. What you got?
The song from the trailer.
It's a good start. It is a good start. I feel a really good start.
There's something in here that's so factual.
I do relate to this a lot, though. Relate to this a lot because of the fact that a girl tells you to go out, be free. What does that mean?
I know that you're hiding something from me that's been close to you.
I relate to this a lot.
Yeah.
In this one, he's saying, okay, is there somebody else or not?
Yeah, you know.
And I feel like relating-wise, I relate to this.
I'm about to tell you the biggest theory about Don FM.
What's up?
He's, the reason why he's old on the cover, right, is because he's tried so many times to rewrite his past.
And the new video that came out, he killed his older version. Like, young Weeknd he sees his older version, and he kills him.
Mm-hmm.
What that kind of reminds me is like, well, it doesn't remind me, it just kind of makes me think like, maybe he's killing his future life by hurting himself now and kind of saying like, I'm not going to be able to live that much because I already killed my future self and I'm basically living my last days. But I relate to, is there someone else?
So, yeah, it's, you know, there's, whenever you have like that feeling of like, okay, there's something wrong here, you know, in a relationship.
Come on.
And the thing that's most annoying or sucks the most is that whenever you find out that there was someone else.
Yes, and you're like, I knew it because I had a feeling about it.
Yeah.
Takes the point. Don FM, baby.
Yeah. Tell you, come back. Come back season.
Two more. Could the next two songs beat After Hours? This is an interlude.
I love the interlude.
Let's see. Like you're related to this right now.
Yes.
Heavy. I can't.
Heavy, bro. Like, you don't even understand. I wish I could talk about it, but it's very personal. But yeah, I feel very empowered.
All right, so now. Okay. Neutral. I'm neutral about it. Very neutral. Let's see what we got. Starry Eyes. Starry Eyes with Donovan. Now, this one is interesting because
Starry Eyes, first time around. You know, honestly, I don't really remember.
I only met you in my dreams before.
It starts out so good.
Not in the world. You were there when I
forgot how it goes.
To call my girl. And now you're my reality.
Dreams came true.
And I wanna feel you close.
Oh yeah.
But you're defeated, baby. Broken, hurting, suffering from a shattered soul.
Like, it starts so good, and it's like this buildup that I'm like, oh my.
Let me be there.
You know,
are we really about to disagree right now?
I just thought it was gonna hit a little harder, you know, like it.
A lot of technical difficulties today, but Starry Eyes.
And you think it's gonna break? It doesn't.
Starry Eyes to me.
I do think
here there's a line in here, or like a couple lines where I'm just like, yeah.
Between those two, I like Starry Eyes. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
How do you feel about it?
So there's a line in here, right? You were there when I needed someone to call my girl, and now you're my reality. And I want to feel close, or I want you to feel close, yeah. But you're defeated. Broken, hurt, and suffering from my shattered soul.
What a philosophical man.
Let me be there. Let me be there for your heart. Let me be there. I could be there until you're whole.
Yeah.
And then he goes on to say,
I wish I could relate to music the way you do sometimes. Because, I don't know. Like, I really want to do that. The only song I've related to is... I mean, there's some songs that I can tell you that I relate a lot.
Yeah.
But for these, like, the way you do, it's like you really relate. I'm like, dude, that's awesome. Like, I wish I could, but somebody that can.
Is it uno, dos, tres, cuatro?
That's right. Dude.
Yeah. Definitely relatable.
Dude, next time we should do, like, songs that mean the most to us and why.
And then and then we just, like, explain it. I kind of like that.
Yeah, that's good. But for now, what's your vote on?
You know, honestly... Interlude, because there's just way more of a connection there to me.
And to
I loved it. I loved the interlude.
I said we call it a draw.
Yeah, I would.
We're at 7-6. Oh my god, Don FM is doing pretty good.
Yeah, it's actually doing pretty good.
Coming here, I'm like, Don FM is gonna lose because I didn't really feel it that much, but hey, let's see now what we got.
We could skip this one.
Why?
No, I'm not saying like it's bad, but I already know what this round is.
Of course. Let's just...
Thought I almost died in my dream again.
I love how this...
Yes! Almost like you want to go walking. You know what I'm saying?
At the mall.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, legit, you know, just like that. Yeah.
Look at you're like...
Right here.
My darkest hours. Girl, I'm up for one long inside of this crowded room.
You know, this one, yeah, you just...
Here's the next song. And
which is this one?
I have mixed feelings about this.
This one is actually crazy.
This one's scary as hell, though.
This one's crazy. I have a very strong opinion about this one, too.
This is a vibe. It's like a mystery, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
This is also a trailer song.
Was it on the trailer?
It was, for sure. Maybe it was this, not the other one. No. I forgot.
I could have sworn it was the other one.
It's for sure this one.
Who, if I cried out,
dude, this is intense.
That's what I'm
saying. Like, it doesn't sound like him. It sounds
even
like
they pressed me against their heart.
Very majestic.
It sounds almost angel-like.
But also creepy
hence,
as hell.
Very angel-like. That's why he's dead.
While he's standing in
I don't think he's dead.
In the storyline? Yeah. Dude, you're dead throughout your whole album. guess that's why he's there. I listen to it as if you want to kill it.
Every angel is terrifying.
This is awesome. This is not, I don't know if you count it as a song, but it's just
no, it's
good.
So good. It's a great transition. Intense,
graphic, sexy, euphoric, provocative, edgy.
No, my thing is, it's
technically and visually stunning. A compelling work of science fiction.
The
Weeknd. A expose. Cinema like you've never seen it before.
Wow, dude, this is
the exotic, bizarre,
else.
And beautiful world of Afterlife. And this is your invitation to enter. Critics say Afterlife makes your current life look like a total comatose snooze fest.
I don't know how to feel about it. Like, it's beautiful, but like,
I don't think it's creepy. Honestly, the beginning of this song
was amazing.
Was great.
It was amazing, yeah.
But After Hours, though, yeah.
I feel like I can vibe to After Hours more than this, because I'm not going to be bobbing my head to, like...
Yeah, I mean...
Exotic, bizarre, beautiful world of Afterlife. With the girl, she's like, okay, you're like...
okay. Oh,
you ready to go to Afterlife? No. Please. But, okay, that makes it 8. All right, what's it? Oh, this is... I'm excited for this one, because this is not even...
Oh, Until I Bleed Out? Oh,
until
man.
Until I Bleed Out.
Oh man, hold on. Which one is this one comparing to? I'm curious.
Damn.
But, oh, man.
Masterpiece.
You know, the next song after this,
what is it? Let me see.
It's one with Lil Wayne, I think.
Oh.
Oh, wait, no, sound. Oh, yeah.
I forgot about this one.
I see you drowning in the purple.
Oh, okay, yeah.
I see purple eyes. On you, you snatch my soul, I'm crucified. I feel paralyzed. I'm so mesmerized by you. But I know you lied to me.
I love this part.
This is intense.
I love this part.
I can taste this one.
Is this
it's just you and I.
It's a Weeknd.
In the disco.
Yeah, yeah. Iron? Yeah, it is.
But don't you worry.
That was really good.
Yeah, it was really good. Definitely.
But Until I Bleed Out is just a freaking.
That's a symphony. Unit. That's a symphony.
Sorry, not FM. It's good, but doesn't beat Until I Bleed Out.
I do resonate with the song a lot too.
I get it. No, I think everybody can to an extent. But, let's see what we got next. Bonus track.
Oh, yeah, bonus tracks. So, After Hours originally ended with Until I Bleed Out. But then, you know, of course, Abel came out with the Deluxe, which had, I think, 3 more songs on it.
So now we got this. I actually haven't heard this.
Really?
I don't think so.
Oh, dude, you're in for a trip. You're in for a trip.
I like it already. Ooh.
Watch this, though.
No, I did hear this.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah.
I've been trying hard to find the words to say.
Oh, I love that voice. Little transition.
If we try it again, we make the same mistake. Oh, nothing compares.
you.
That's so true.
But hold a minute, though.
I can't. But I wish I could talk about it, but.
But hold a minute, though.
Oh, yeah. Okay. All right, look.
This, I don't think you can relate.
I don't have to relate. This one, yeah. I love this song. I'm gonna tell you right now, this one tops the other one.
I'm very neutral about it, so I'll let you pick this one.
Okay. Oh, man, keep going. If you don't love him, then do yourself a favor and just leave
it. You know my phone, I'm going to delete it. Makes sense, dude. It's how it's supposed to be.
Can't be your private, make me your obvious. If I ain't your husband, I can't be your hybrid. I heard you married. I bet he treats you like Virgin Mary. You like it dirty and I'm dirty Harry. I know you with some lovers, canaries, word to Larry. But I can't fuck with you. You put my love on the line and hang up on you. That's a long kiss goodbye, I got a tongue for you.
It's just the whole idea of a girl cheating on her dude because of you.
Yeah, 100%.
Interesting. And what was 100%. It against? It was against... Nothing Compares. I'm not familiar with Nothing Compares, and I don't know.
Honestly,
I like this beat though better, in my opinion. Like, it's, I really it's can't very relate 50-50. To either of those. It's
very honestly, this is a very good matchup.
It is.
Honestly.
Draw.
Yeah, draw it. It's what, 8-6? No, 9-6. No, 10-7. So right now there's no way Don of him can come back, but now I'm telling you right now, this song you're about to play is my favorite song
on the whole album.
Out of the whole album, and it was a bonus.
That's it.
Convince myself to run around with someone else to forget about you.
I'm about to start crying on cam.
This is an open podcast.
I said your name by mistake, played it off like I'm just confused. But I was frontin', lying to myself.
Right here.
The truth was I missed you.
Your laugh must be very, very movie-like when it comes to relationships.
You know the funny thing is that yes, it really is. It really is.
So much drama, so much action, so much.
No, legit, bro. Like, I am serious about that.
That's crazy, dude.
Like, whenever I'm dating someone, it is legit a movie.
Nevertheless, so that one is going against this song. Less Than Zero.
Oh, this one's crazy.
Remember I was your hero.
I do like this one a lot. I love this one.
Yeah. I'd wear your heart like a symbol.
Oh no, he doesn't.
I couldn't see you from my darkest truth of all.
This is like a theme. Like,
yeah. Right here, yeah. Right here, boy.
Oh,
shit. I was getting so excited.
Me too.
I thought it was right there.
By the way, I still have the tag because I got 30 days before I can return this, so I'm keeping it with me. You know what I mean?
Hey, that's how you save money right there. I'm serious. Like, I just recently took this one off.
There we go. Here we go.
Okay, here it is this time.
I can't shake this feeling that grows in my bed.
Okay.
No, actually, it was.
Oh.
Yeah. But it was a very cool experience. I actually learned a lot from it.
Nevertheless, anyways, last up we have Final Lullaby.
Perfect timing, because it is late at night.
It is late at night. It's not as late as yesterday, though. No. We left at 2 a.m.
No, I didn't.
What?
Yeah, that's...
You got home at 2 a.m.
Yeah.
I'm running out of time. And you're always be on my mind. And I hope you find peace. Close your eyes.
I don't even want to talk during this one, just because, like, such a vibe. I love this one.
And I can make you stay in this broken place. And I hope you find peace. Close your eyes and I put us to sleep.
I'm not even going to say anything. We're just going to go to the last song from Don FM. I want to hear the whole thing. I want to play the whole thing.
Jim Carrey went in on this shit, bro.
You're tuned to Don FM. The middle of nowhere on your dial.
This feels so sad for no reason.
So sit back and unpack. Yeah.
It's such a sad thing.
You may be here a while. Now that all future plans have been postponed, and it's time to look back on the things you thought you owned, do you remember them well?
I love this.
Were you high or just stoned?
It's like a wake up check.
And how many grudges did you take to your grave?
Right here.
When you weren't liked or followed, how did you behave? Was it often a dissonant chord you were strumming?
Mm-hmm.
Were you ever in tune with the song life was humming?
Facts.
With the pains living on, when the sun's long gone, and your phantom regret hasn't let it go yet, you may not have died in the way that you must. All specters are haunted by their own lack of trust.
Wow, it's a
when you're all out of time, there's it nothing but space. No hunting, no gathering, no nations, no race. And heaven is closer than those tears on your face.
Wow,
I know.
When the purple rain falls, we're all bathed in its grace.
Mm-hmm.
Heaven's for those who let go of regret.
Yeah.
You have to wait here when you're not all there yet. But you could be there by the end of this song.
With a weekend
so good and he plays all week long. Bang a gong, get it on. And if your broken heart's heavy when you step on the scale, you'll be lighter than air when they pull back the veil.
Yikes.
Consider the flowers, they don't try to look right. They just open their petals and turn to the light. Are you listening real close? Heaven's not that, it's this. It's the depth of this moment. You don't reach for bliss. God knows life is chaos, but he made one thing true. You gotta unwind your mind, train your soul to align.
This is my favorite line.
Dance till you find that divine boogaloo.
I had to look up what that meant.
I don't even know what boogaloo means.
It's a dance.
No, really?
It's a type of disco dance, yeah.
To see heaven. To see heaven.
And then he says,
may peace.
This is beautiful.
Be with you.
This is beautiful. Easily takes the dub. Easily takes the dub.
Yeah, absolutely. And for those who don't know, this is actually the album is in a way where it makes a perfect loop. For those who didn't know. So,
last score, ladies and gentlemen. It turns out we got After Hours 10 and Don FM with a whooping 7.
Yeah, whooping 7.
Close. It was a close.
It was close at one point. It was close at one point.
It's still kind of close. Just 3 songs.
Yeah, just 3 songs.
Wow.
But if we would have included, Blinding Lights.
Blinding Lights.
Yeah, that would have been 4.
It would have been, yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, I was not expecting.
It was a lot closer. I was expecting After Hours just
to be like
clean, 16, just to clean it out.
14-2
To clean it out.
At the end of the day, you know, it's a Weeknd. The Weeknd, he made both of these albums, so of course it's gonna be amazing. So, but that's awesome, dude. Like, I think that's the best person who could possibly just narrate that.
Exactly.
I didn't even know he was a narrator. He hasn't narrated anything before. But
yeah, no. He's never really narrated like that before.
Yeah, like I've never would expected it, but it was perfect. Amazing.
It was perfect. Yes. It was a perfect thing. You know, he's a very sad guy. You know,
he is, dude. If you ever see his interviews, he whips out the most unusual dialogues and the most craziest ideas, and I'm like, all right, that's interesting. So now seeing him do this,
it just comes.
It's awesome. It's just a masterpiece.
It's definitely a masterpiece.
Pierce, if we're watching this, I bought your tickets, or at least one of my friends bought tickets for your concert, and
it
got canceled. So.
Hey, he's coming back. He's coming back.
You're coming back. He's coming back after hours till dawn, baby.
Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
Oh man, that's crazy.
After hours till dawn.
That's crazy.
All right. Well, thank you all so much for watching this. I think we've concluded this battle. Obviously, After Hours takes the prize, 10-7.
Takes the dub on.
However,
this one.
It's the Weeknd. I think both albums had
amazing songs
that we can vibe to, and.
Yeah. But again, it's all based on our preference, you know.
It is all based on preference. So why don't you go ahead and tell us what your favorite song was from each?
Drop it in the comments.
Yeah,
below.
What is your favorite? So you say your favorite song from After Hours was
Missed You. Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Missed You. Mine is Too Late, just because it goes hard.
Yeah.
Donifam, favorite song from Donifam.
Oh. I would have to say Best Friends.
Best Friends is so good. That's my second favorite.
It's either Best Friends. Or
How Do I Make You Love Me?
Yeah.
All right. Well,
bet.
You guys go ahead and click that subscribe button, turn on the notifications.
And
what else? Comment down the most random crap you can.
Yeah,
We don't care.
We don't care. It's a very open community. Now don't go after each other, but.
Don't go after each other. I mean, if you start a fight in the comments, that's completely okay by us too. I mean, we'll try to hop in and see how we can, like, moderate.
Yeah, you know, we'll break it down. But.
For now, we'll just keep you updated for the next episode of Garage Session.
Garage Sale?
Garage Sale. It don't matter, so.
Shoot. Drink water.
Good. If you like our equipment, you can always donate so we can get better.
Yes. This guy.
All right.
This guy. It's time to go.